Hello.
I'm going to give a short tutorial on the TPS, the Timber Plate Structures plugin, which you can download for free on the foodforrhino.com website. I'm going to open the example files that come with this application. If you open the Rhino file first, example 1 diamond, what you see is a NURBS surface. It's just example, you might use your own surface. And then if we open the grasshopper file that comes with it, there is one file that's called example 1b that goes with this geometry, diamond analyze. It is meant to actually show you the fold angles of this diamond fold that you're generating. If I go and hide the actual surface, we will see this color scheme here that shows us which of the fold angles are very obtuse. You see these are close to 150 degree fold angles, very flat. And then over here they are more acute, something like 115 degrees, 120 degrees maximum, which is when it starts to go into the orange color. So this might be important for the type of joint that we want to apply. There are some joints, like miter joints, which you can generate with this plugin, where this does not matter. You can actually ignore the red colors here. Still something you can design and fabricate. But there's also a component that's called TPS, multiple tap and slot joints. And this might generate joints like dovetails, which you cannot apply to edges with very obtuse angles. So those wouldn't work on these areas. So if you want to design something that is using dovetail joints, then this is the application where you can actually make sure that the angles are good for what you want to do. In this case, you might have to, for example, change your basic shape, or you just change the division settings. You see that I increased the V division here a little bit, and suddenly this gets a lot more acute angles in this area. Then we can actually go and look at the example 1A, diamond miter joints, which would be one way of turning this geometry, which was right now having no plate thickness and no details, into actual three-dimensional plate geometry. It will take a polygon mesh as an input, which you can connect here, and then you have the options of setting a plate thickness and a chamfer size. So we can see this here in the live demo. We can change the plate thickness, and since we have the flat plates option turned on, which is going to give us automatically laid out plates on the XY plane of the world, we can change the thickness of the plates, and it's going to affect the 3D model, and it's going to affect these laid out plates. Also, every one of the plates in the XY plane is going to automatically have the same color and the same number than it has in the 3D model. And since this is connected with the component that is at the same time generating the fold, which is underlying, we could also change these values. We could change the division value here, and we would at the same time get the update for the laid out plates. If you now want to go and turn this into actual Rhino geometry or export it to another software package, you would have to go to either the polylines that come out of this and bake them. So this would give you the lines, which you can, for example, use with the fabrication plugin that also comes with this package. Or you go to the other output of this component, which is going to give you a closed poly mesh for each one of these plates. I can say bake, and now if we would close all of this, you would see that we have plates for each one of these objects. And also if you turn it to wireframe, you see that for each plate we have a number, which is lines, which is going to show you which of the plates in the actual model this is representing. Okay, so a little bit more advanced, if you want to use not just the miter joint, but if you want to use dovetail joints, this is shown in the example 2, diamond dovetails. For this explanation, it's going to be using a bit more simple geometry. And we're going to open the example 2, diamond dovetails grasshopper definition. So you see this is pretty much the same as the miter joint component, only that for each of these plates we have to define directions of assembly, and this is something that the plugin can currently not do automatically. So if we would start with a geometry, like we just opened it in the Rhino file, of course that's just a simple polygon mesh, it does not yet have this definition list here. We have to do this, and I'm going to just type a random number here and delete it for now. Then you will see what the plugin is going to do automatically. If you would do this yourself, you would be starting with something like this. The plugin is generating automatically an insertion vector which is perpendicular to the edge. This would be a classic dovetail joint. And that's absolutely fine for a lot of assemblies, like a rectangular box, but on the complex shape that we're looking at here, we have to do some manual definitions, because let's take a look at this. We have here two edges on this pink part, and they are not parallel. But we have to assemble them at the same time, which means that this direction for the joint, it needs to be the same. And this standard suggestion that the plugin makes with the perpendicular vectors, it's not something that we can assemble. So instead, what we have to do is we have to use the bisector between these two edges, which is going to give us a very nice line of insertion for these two joints. And in order to get this line, we can, for example, go into Rhino. We use the bisector function, and then we have to make sure that in our O snap, the vertex snap is activated. We're going to first click the vertex of this plate, and then the other two vertices out here, and it's going to give us between these two edges that we want to assemble at the same time this line here. Going to just draw it quickly, and this line is exactly the direction of assembly for these two edges. So the example includes a little helper which lets you turn this into a unit vector. You can basically just take any two points that you like on this line, and what you get is the unit vector which we can copy. And then we have to apply it for these two edges. And now this might actually be a little bit difficult to see the identifiers of these edges. So what we can do is we can quickly go to the input options of the TPS MTSJ component. We can turn off the solids, we turn it to false, and it's going to quickly show us only the wireframe. Now we have here the identifier 28 and we have the identifier 39. Now we can actually go to the insertion vectors, and we can take our number 28 for the identifier, edge ID, and then we're going to insert the number we have just copied from our little helper tool. And we have to remove nays. And then you see it automatically giving us the correct joint geometry for edge 28. Now we are actually going to want the same vector for edge 39. So what we can do is we can basically just go here, type 39, and paste the same vector. And now you see something that can happen is that the edge is oriented in a different way. So all of these edges, they are oriented, and they may be oriented towards this vertex or away from it. And this is going to affect the direction that we need to input for the insertion vector. So the direction here is correct, but in this case, the direction of the edge is flipped. So to get the correct joint geometry, you see this is not interlocking here. If it looks like this, then we need to invert this vector on edge 39. So every plus becomes a minus, every minus becomes a plus, and it's going to give us the correct joint geometry. So you see, we have successfully done this for plate number 7. These two directions are the same, just the vector is flipped for edge 39. And now if we turn the solids on again, you see that we have a perfectly correct geometry for this plate, which could be fabricated and inserted, because these two edges have the exact same direction. You can bake this geometry if you bake the plate meshes. Then you could also see if you can align this direction here that we've given for these joints with the actual profiles of the plates. So you see this is for both edges, this is the same direction. Okay, so this is how you would have to define it for every set of edges that you assemble at the same time. This explains how this is going to be used. Thank you very much for watching.